You may have seen bottles of kombucha at your local grocery store, or met someone who makes sauerkraut at home and wondered how ingesting microorganisms can improve health. Nowadays, foods and beverages rich in probiotics gain popularity. What are probiotics? Bacteria are commonly associated with the disease. Probiotics, however, are known as good bacteria or helpful bacteria. The term probiotic is a combination of the Latin prefix pro, meaning for, and the Greek noun bios, meaning life. So, literally, term probiotics means for life. The term probiotic generally refers to beneficial microorganisms living in the gut. They are naturally found in your body, but they are also found in many foods, drinks, and supplements. Keep on watching to learn more about how probiotics work, how they affect your health, and ways you can include them in your diet. Probiotics. The good bacteria. In fact, the average human has as many bacterial cells as it does human cells. The trillions of microorganisms that call our bodies home are commonly known as microbiome. The microorganisms that live in our digestive systems are known as the gut microbiome. There are more than 20 types of bacteria considered probiotics, mostly in the lactobacillus or bifidobacterium families. These are the key types of beneficial bacteria to look out for when adding probiotics to your diet. They support your digestive system, as well as other aspects of your health. Healthy gut means strong immune system. Today, millions of people are affected by the digestive disease. This has attracted the attention of doctors and scientists trying to understand the various factors contributing to digestive health. Scientists believe that ingesting probiotics helps restore the ratio between good and bad bacteria in your gut. Eating fermented foods and drinking fermented beverages are simple ways to introduce lactic acid bacteria or lab into the gastrointestinal, or GI, tract. The benefits of consuming probiotics. Improving intestinal tract health. Enhancing the immune system. Synthesizing and enhancing the bioavailability of nutrients. Reducing symptoms of lactose intolerance. Decreasing the prevalence of allergies. The antioxidant and inflammation support capabilities of probiotics may also show strong health benefits beyond the stomach. One of the more emerging applications of probiotics is linked to the gut-brain connection and their potential to support your nervous system, thus affecting your mood and being able to ease stress. Fermentation. Fermented foods have been traditionally known for their healing properties for hundreds of years. Throughout human history, fermentation has been a reliable method to preserve and improve the flavor of food. Fermentation, which creates probiotic-rich food and drinks, is a process by which bacteria and yeast consume sugars, then expel acids, gases, and alcohol. In fermented foods, like kimchi or sauerkraut, the beneficial bacteria digest sugars and produce lactic acid, which acts as a natural preservative and defense against harmful bacteria. It's interesting that the two most common strains of beneficial bacteria found in the human digestive system are Lactobacillus acidophilus and Bifidobacterium bifidum, which are also abundant in fermented foods and beverages. Fermented foods. As you might expect from an ancient practice, fermented foods have found established places in cultures from around the world. You are probably quite familiar with a number of the most common fermented foods and drinks from around the world. Yogurt is thought to have originated in Mesopotamia before spreading throughout the Middle East and the Mediterranean. Kefir is a fermented milk drink similar to yogurt. It is thought to have originated in the Caucasus Mountains before spreading across the globe. Miso, originally from Japan, made from fermented soybeans and grains and contains millions of beneficial bacteria. Kombucha is a Japanese name for a drink originating in China, made by fermenting sweet tea. There are countless recipes for fermented vegetables, including pickled cucumbers from Russia and India, kimchi from Korea, sauerkraut from Germany. Make sure you eat at least one probiotic-packed product daily to keep your gut healthy and your immune system strong. If you don't typically eat probiotic foods, consider taking a probiotic in supplement form. How to find the right supplement? The dosing for probiotics is measured in something called colony-forming units or CFUs, the number of active cells with the potential to grow and multiply. A typical dose of a probiotic supplement will include between 1 and 10 billion active CFUs. Probiotic supplements are typically found in capsule form, but are also available in tablet, liquid, and even gummy form. The most effective formulations and delivery methods for providing viable probiotic cells are still being studied and developed. Choosing a proven blend of bacteria strain is important, so be sure to check the labels of any probiotic supplements you buy. Lactobacillus acidophilus and Bifidobacterium bifidum are known to be the most common strains of beneficial bacteria found in the human digestive system, which makes them good choices for supplementation. Please note that taking probiotic supplements is only be a temporarily supporting measure. Those simply help to stimulate the population of your own bacteria and replace what has been lost. Taking supplements is very important when you experience stress, illness, or have to take antibiotics. Here is an interesting fact about probiotics. Did you know that your gut-brain connection is a two-way street? Not only can gut bacteria influence the brain, but the brain can also influence gut bacteria. The psychological stress suppresses beneficial bacteria. For example, in one study, stool samples taken from university students during exam week contained fewer lactobacilli than the samples taken earlier in the semester. Similarly, in mice, living with stress has been linked to decreased numbers of beneficial bacteria and an overgrowth of harmful bacteria, thus making the critters more susceptible to infection and gut inflammation. So, keep calm to support your microbiome. It's also important to mention that the latest studies have shown that your microbiome is unique. So it is much better to support your own microbiome by feeding your bacteria with prebiotics, which are namely lots of different types of fiber. We'll talk about prebiotics in the next video. Stay tuned. And see you next week. For more videos, subscribe to our channel now.